Thanks, John. Hi, everybody. Good morning. Welcome. If this is your first time at EIS, I can't keep track of how many times I've been here, but this is my favorite conference of the year, also the spring event. If you haven't been to the spring event, it's another wonderful event as well. So thrilled to be here again and very humbled to be able to present to you guys today. As John mentioned, my name is Anthony Chiulli, Director of Product Marketing at Cordial. If you're unfamiliar with us, we are a cross-channel marketing platform that allows customers to bring all of their data into the platform and then activate that across a myriad of different channels, including email, SMS, and mobile app. We work with a lot of really cool brands, some of you, or some of which, are in the room with us today. So if you've ever gotten an email from Bayer Minerals, which is Orveon, or perhaps an SMS message from Eddie Bauer or L.L. Bean, or perhaps you tried to get outfitted for this conference this year and you did some shopping at Backcountry, which is just down the street in Salt Lake, and maybe got a push message over Black Friday. Those are all brands that trust Cordial to send a better message. But sending a better message is more than just a tagline for us. It's something that we really try to aspire and working with our clients to do. And it's not easy. We've been coming to this conference for many years and proud sponsors of this conference. And the themes have evolved, as Roger's talked about over the years. But we don't have it solved out yet. That's why we're here. That's why we're here learning and networking and presenting on the latest trends in email marketing. So this is the challenge for modern marketing today. Marketers are overwhelmed. They're spending excessive amounts of time synchronizing and managing data across a very disjointed stack. And they're trying to move beyond personalization and truly try to understand humans at scale. So the result is marketers really want to get back to being creative. They want to be innovative. And we took a few folks out to dinner last night and we asked everyone about why they got into marketing. And surprisingly, no one said to pull lists and segment audiences and code emails and do all of the mundane, heads down, manual tasks that we all find ourselves in. A lot of folks got into marketing to be creative, to be marketers, to be strategic, and that's what our mission is. The good news is we're in a new era of marketing, and you'll hear a lot about AI over the course of the next 2 to 3 days. You've heard some great presenters, including Gary and others, that have talked about this and their lines of business. And this is a really, really exciting time, not only for technology providers, but also marketers alike. And I truly believe this does have the impact to truly transform the way that we market and revolutionize the way that we do our jobs moving forward. So there's a lot to unpack with AI, and it's very fast moving, it's evolving, it's a very exciting time, but it really does matter what's under the hood when you talk about applying AI in your roles, in your departments, in your teams. So if you think about the past decade or so, the primary challenge for marketers was really trying to captivate and culminate and collect all of this data. And there's more data being generated by our consumers than ever before. There's a lot of stats and reports on the amount of data being generated. It's overwhelming. These numbers don't make sense to me in terms of how they're described, but it's a lot of data is the point. Because we are expanding channels. There's new channels that are coming online. There's new ways to engage with brands. So there's more opportunities, more devices, more interactions and touch points that are generating masses of amounts of data. And in fact, Cordial was born from this problem. So in 2014, we started our business and we started with a data-first platform that really tried to help brands take advantage of all of this data, bring it into the Cordial platform, unify and transform that, and activate it across channels. But by and large, this problem is actually solved for. A lot of platforms today do this quite well, and platforms that don't aren't here anymore, or close to not being here anymore. But this is an opportunity and a challenge, right? So there's all of this data, and the opportunity is, this is what drives personalization, this is what makes teams data-driven, and this is what fuels the potential for AI, is the data that you have. The challenge is making sense of all of this data, especially in its varying formats and its different shapes that it takes, and truly applying this into your AI strategy. So the next important challenge that we feel is on the precipice for marketers is what we are calling the shape of data. And the shape of data is basically refers to as the characteristics of the data, perhaps its dimensions, or the way that it's organized in the platform. And this directly impacts the influence and application of AI in your marketing strategies and the insights that you can derive from that. So when we think about data, there's kind of two different types. There's this constrained data, This is a data that's typically organized in tables with rows and columns. It's very structured, it's very organized, it's easy to query. So think of this as like a well-organized filing cabinet, which is a throwback reference, but labels, organized, it's very intuitive, right? So examples for this could be profile attributes or purchase events or engagement activity. The next challenge, or the next type of data, I should say, is kind of this data that takes multiple shapes. And this is actually a majority, over 80 to 90% of the data that's generated today falls into this category. So this is data that's perhaps not well organized. It's not very structured. It's more qualitative than quantitative. But this is like a huge pile of documents being dumped out on the table. It's very ambitious and it's very daunting to deal with that, but there's rich and valuable insights in that type of data. So an example of this, like a tangible example of this would be, think about like a subscription business versus a mattress company, right? They're both retailers, but the data and the shape of their data are drastically different between those two business models. So if you look at many platforms today, they're often treated the same. There's the same schema applied to both of those businesses, even though they're quite differently in terms of how they operate. So Cordial saw this as an opportunity, and we kind of architected our platform to be extremely robust and flexible in the way that we store and allow our clients to organize and transform their data on our platform. So why does all this matter in terms of AI, which is what we're here to talk about at this conference, is because data is the fuel and AI is the accelerator. It's an incredibly exciting time to be in marketing, but in order to harness the full power of AI, you have to have the right marketing technology, and you have to have the ability to process and analyze a wide variety of data shapes. So when you're looking at the platform and the ecosystems today, there are almost all platforms are coming out with generative AI capabilities and features and functionalities. There's a huge boom and hype in terms of innovation and releases around AI, but a lot of these platforms are very limited in terms of their rigid data architecture. And it kind of restricts the ideas and the insights that you can glean from slapping on AI onto a platform. So it does train on a lot of structured data, that's great, but it's very rigid in terms of its feature sets or its models that it's applying. And the result is its conformity. It's more of this one-size-fits-all AI application to clients, and every client is different. Every client is unique, even if they're in the same vertical. So it's kind of interesting for me to see, especially the hype and the boom of AI, where there's all of these press releases coming out about AI capabilities and features. And it's difficult for me to read in product marketing because they all kind of just sound the same. They're all kind of checking a box. We have AI. We have an API into some sort of LLM, and they move on. At Cordial, we're really thinking about the future of AI in fundamentally different ways. So yes, we have generative AI capabilities. We have content and subject line and image creation. But we're thinking so much broader and so much bigger in terms of the future of AI for our clients. So our platform strength lies in the ability to support multiple data shapes and dynamic ways. And this really creates this new opportunity for brands to truly understand their customers as humans at scale. So it's really about making the most of your data no matter what shape or form it takes. So as we move forward, and AI continues to play a bigger role and influences marketing in completely new ways, the ability to process a wide variety of data shape really matters, not just the scale, but also the form that it takes. And we're really excited about our roadmap with AI and a platform like Cordial to truly take advantage of this concept. And we're not just thinking about it for your end consumers. We're really thinking about how AI can impact and benefit you as the marketer in engaging with our platform and our technology in more intuitive ways. So I've got a couple colleagues here with me this week, Christine and Chris, if you guys don't mind just raising your hands, putting a face to the name. So we'd love to follow up with you or chat AI in the coffee break. And again, thank you for the Media Post team. Appreciate it.